evening, a day after the WDSU I-Team told you about a man who had been arrested 10 times for DWI and was still behind the wheel, we're learning about action planned by the city's inspector general.
WDSU News anchor Scott Walker talks about where the city could potentially go from here and what the inspector general plans to do with all the DWI cases at traffic court in the coming months. Scott?
Norman, Camille, one man, 10 DWI arrests and no prosecutions. George Sims has managed to avoid trial in all of the cases dating back to 1984, a span of nearly 30 years, and all the cases are still pending. Now the city and the inspector general are considering what is next. Because of our investigation, New Orleans Traffic Court became aware of George Sims' extensive file, 10 DWI arrests since 1984, along with citations for failing to appear in court, switching his license plate, reckless operation, hit and run, and more.
But we don't know what's taking so long to go through the process.
Defense attorney Robert Jenkins, who is not connected to any of Sims' cases, says his 10 open DWIs raise serious questions.
It's unusual. I don't know where that has been a breakdown, or maybe there's just been a lack of evidence in all 12 cases. I don't know, which is totally highly unusual, so I can't say that. All I can look at is what you gave me, and it's highly unusual, this type of situation.
During our surveillance of Sims, WDSU cameras caught him behind the wheel, leaving his New Orleans business address on Serampereau Street. And when the I-Team requested the extensive traffic court files for Sims, Judge Ronald Scholes became aware of his record and ordered Sims arrested last Monday.
The court is lacking oversight and has engaged in all sorts of poor management at the very least.
New Orleans Inspector General Ed Quattrovo has been highly critical of traffic court and told the I-Team exclusively that DWIs will soon be a major focus of his office.
We're going to do a review of all the DWI cases. We decided to do that based on what we saw in our review of traffic court with respect to the non-DWI. So we want to take a look at that, and we're going to do that project, and we'll probably do it in 2012.
On top of that, Mayor Mitch Landrieu's office says the city is considering sending Sims cases to the U.S. Attorney's Office for further investigation. In a statement to WDSU, New Orleans City Attorney Richard Cortizas said Sims' avoidance of the court system never should have happened. Cortizas said, quote, "In this particular matter, it does not appear that any of the cases in question were set for trial by the courts. It's totally unacceptable."
It appears that it's a pretty lenient court.
Sims spent 3 nights in jail before bonding out last Thursday. On Friday morning, we confronted Sims, but before we could talk to him, the driver of the car he was riding in sped away. His next court date is set for March 6th. And local reaction has been strong since our investigation aired. Tonight on WDSU News at 10, harsh words for a man who lost his son in a drunk driving incident back in 2006. And a reaction from the local branch of Mothers Against Drunk Driving. Plus, your thoughts from our Facebook page. Norman?
All right, Scott, remember, WDSU's Best I-Team stories come from you, our viewers. If you have information on corruption or other wrongdoing that you'd like us to investigate, send us an email at newsdesk@wdsu.com.